In this video, we will demonstrate how to create custom GPS scenarios using the Agilent N7609B Signal Studio for Global Navigation Satellite System software with option RFP for scenario generation. Here is the equipment setup used for this demonstration. The N7609B Signal Studio software runs inside the N5106A PXB baseband generator and channel emulator to create the GPS baseband signal in the PXB. This digital baseband signal is then sent over an LVDS digital bus to the N5182A MXG signal generator, where it is upconverted to the GPS RF frequency and sent to the GPS receiver, a UBlocks 5H evaluation kit. The GPS receiver sends its information via a USB interface to the UBlocks UCenter evaluation software for display. Let's start by showing how to create custom scenarios with the N7609B Signal Studio software. On the Scenario Generator tab, we select Create as the generation mode and leave the scenario type at the default setting of static to create a scenario for a stationary GPS receiver. We provide an almanac file name, input the longitude, latitude, and altitude for the location of the scenario, and provide the starting date and time and the required duration of the scenario. The location given here is for San Francisco, California. There are also options to specify an elevation mask angle or to include modeling for impairment from the troposphere and the ionosphere. To generate the scenario file, we click on the Create Scenario button, and the software will ask for a scenario file name. As you see here, a scenario with a 1 hour duration takes just a few seconds to create. Once the file has been saved, we can go to the GPS Settings tab to select and play the scenario. The resulting GPS receiver signal is shown in the UCenter software. Notice that the green cross on the world map indicates the general location of the GPS receiver for the scenario. Let's now take a look at how we create dynamic scenarios to simulate moving GPS receivers. On the Scenario Generator tab, we again select Create for the generation mode and provide the almanac file name as we did previously. This time, we select Dynamic as the scenario type. For a dynamic scenario, we need to input the trajectory path for the moving GPS receiver by using an NMEA GGA format file. The GGA file contains the location information for the receiver, sampled at a set rate over the time duration of the scenario, so there's no need to input an initial location or time. Here we select a GGA file that was previously created. It is for a GPS receiver that is moving clockwise around a circle with a 1 kilometer radius at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour. We also provide the start date for the scenario. The time information will come from the GGA file. We then create and save the scenario file. We go back to the GPS Settings tab and select this new scenario for playback. For this scenario, we will use the deviation map display in the UCenter software. The center of this circle represents the center of the 1 kilometer circular route. We can see the results of the GPS scenario as the GPS receiver correlates the satellites and begins to calculate a location fix. Here, we see that the GPS receiver is moving in a clockwise route around the circle with a 1 kilometer radius. The speedometer function displays the speed of about 100 kilometers per hour as we expect. In conclusion, GPS receiver verification requires a GPS simulator capable of recreating real-life scenarios. In this video, we've demonstrated how the N7609B Signal Studio software can be used to create custom scenarios for stationary and moving GPS receivers. For more information, please contact your local Agilent Technologies representative or go to the web at www.agilent.com.